What's good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to discuss the basic wave, the WWE basic wave that changed the landscape of WWE action figures forever. At least we think it's forever. I don't know if it's totally forever, but we'll get into it. So if you guys did not know exactly what I'm talking about or what basic wave it is that changed WWE figures as we know them, I think there's a mosquito in this room. And it bit me on the arm, and now my damn arm is itchy. Yep, there it is. Bit me on the arm, Brad. Just like this basic wave bit me on the ass cheek. I had to fight everyone in this room. And that includes me. So today, ladies and gentlemen, we are discussing this basic wave. And if you guys wanted to know what this basic wave is, I'll tell you right now exactly what it is. WWE Basic Figure Series 77. You're probably like, what the hell is that? That probably doesn't even ring a bell. It probably not even in your brain right now. So this specific basic wave, I'll pull up the pictures, guys. This featured Roman Reigns, Finn Balor, Seth Rollins, Corey Graves, and Dean Ambrose. You know, pretty solid wave, wouldn't you think? You got the full Shield. The entire Shield is in this wave. Finn Balor, who I think had just recently hit the main roster, I'm pretty sure, or he hadn't been on the roster that long. It's been a few months since he's been on the main roster. Then you have the brand new, you know, first time on the line, Corey Graves, suited figure. Very nice stuff. I'll get into that wave anyway. We'll break down the wave a little bit more, but that was the consistency of the wave. And I actually remember this specifically because I actually was doing deals with a different company. I was not doing things with Ringside at this time. And this other, you know, website actually sent me WWE action figures, and they sent me this wave. This was one of the first shipments I got of brand new WWE figures. I think it was like Elite Series 53 featuring Kevin Owens. It was Elite 52 and then Elite Series 53. So you had the Seth Rollins, the Braun Strowman. I think the New Day was a part of that set. We had Elite 53 with The Miz and Kevin Owens and Alexa Bliss. And I'll even bring up, maybe I can plug in some imagery or a little bit of footage from that basic video where we actually reviewed these basics and broke them down.
But you can bend the elbow, not very far at all, and it's less than a regular older basic. And then you no longer have bicep swivel, it's entire arm swivel, as you see right here. Jesus Christ, I hope they don't do this again. I do not like that. You can't do arm swaps anymore, and it's just terrible. Don't go with this because I'm not a fan of it. I'll show you the ankle articulation. So there is no longer ankle articulation like you would have seen with an older basic. There's nothing now. So all you get is the boot swivel. You don't get ankle or nothing.
Little did I know, I did not think that this would be a whole thing that actually spiraled out of control and created what we know now as WWE figures. So you're probably thinking to yourself, MDT, what the hell are you talking about, man? What's wrong with this wave? Well, Bradley, if you take a little bit of a closer look, if you examine the action figures, man, you will notice exactly what is wrong with them right at the top, man. Look at their shoulders. Look at these action figures, man. Basic Series 77 is where WWE basic figures bit the dust. So let's go take a look at Basic Series 76 before we got here. So actually, Basic Series 76 was a pretty good wave, I would say. It wasn't the best wave. Don't get me wrong. It wasn't the best wave, but it wasn't a bad wave whatsoever. You had AJ Styles, Macho King, Dolph Ziggler, Sami Zayn, The Rock, and John Cena. I think this was around the time we got Elite Series 51, so you got a repeat of that yelling AJ Styles head sculpt. You got the repeat of the Elite 51 Sami Zayn head sculpt. And this is kind of where, like, Rock figures and Cena figures kind of got on my nerves because they keep releasing this same shirt, you know, over the torso Cena and shirt over the torso Rock figure. So those really get on my nerves. Freaking mosquito, man. I had a... But in this wave, we still had old arm articulation, man. This AJ Styles looked really good. The Dolph Ziggler had the skinny arms. Great attire. This is SummerSlam 2016 attire. He had the Elite 48 head sculpt on there. Really nice basic. Like a lot of people will tell you, that's a really good basic figure right there. So breaking down this line, man, from Series 76 over into 77. God, now I'm just itching. Now I'm just itching everywhere. I killed one of their family members, and now they want me dead. So from Series 76 over to Series 77, man, they changed up basics entirely. I don't even remember them giving us a heads up about it. I don't remember them being like, you know, here's what... I mean, they probably did that. If they didn't tell us, I know why they didn't tell us, because everyone hates them. You know, they would probably be like, what the hell? I didn't know really, like, once they changed it, I didn't really, like, it didn't fathom to me that, oh my God, like, you know, this is it. Like, basics will be terrible forever. But there it was, man. Basic Series 77. 7 came out, and I remember, like, breaking down the wave and just being like, dude, these feel god-awful, you know? Like, the kick pads, like, I felt like if you tried to remove the kick, like, the looseness of the joints and, like, the just real stiffy, liffy type garbage that you got going on, I didn't like it whatsoever. I've mentioned the Jeff Hardy thing before, you know, where, you know, Jeff Hardy came in the company, I was super hyped for the basic figures because we could swap out the arms. You could literally just pop off the arms, put them on an Elite. I miss that so much, just being able to do that straight up with Elite figures, man, and those days are long gone, Brad. Gotta buy old basics, which isn't a big deal, but still, man, there's so many, like, fix-ups that we could have done with Jeff Hardy, man. Like, geez, with sleeves and stuff. God. But you really want to know what really pissed me off? Like, 77 was bad, like, as far as, like, articulation and stuff. But first of all, I'll come back to the Corey Graves figure. But if we look at Basic Series 78, Basic Series 78, when they went to this packaging specifically, I don't know what it was, but it made the figures look cheaper. Am I insane? I just did not like the layout of the packaging. You remember this Natalya figure? This Natalya is probably my least favorite figure that Mattel's ever printed out of a factory ever because it can't stand up. The ankles are super stiff. Like, obviously, these basics are kind of, you know, stiff anyways, but, like, that Rock figure from Series 78 was super stiff. Oh, man. I think all of these figures, literally, or most of them, are in my crowd to this day because I don't have a usage for them. But I remember this packaging specifically not really liking it at all. Like, when I saw the packaging, I was just like, ugh, that's kind of, ugh. I don't know what it is. I really can't explain it. But if you go back and look at Basic Series 76, look at the packaging of Basic Series 76. You got the colors in there. You got the legendary yellow stripe for the Legend. You got the blue for SmackDown Superstars. You got the Raw for the Raw Superstars. I don't know why the Rock has the SmackDown and the Cena has the SmackDown. Or I know the Cena has the SmackDown, but the Rock having the SmackDown, I don't know what's going on with that. However, I don't know, man. It's just like, once we got Basic Series 77, and Basic Series 77, they changed even the Raw graphics. I remember Raw, you know, they changed the graphics for Raw there. Dude, I literally got bit like 4 times by that mosquito. I don't know what to do. Arms itching like hell. But on Basic Series 77, everybody was a Raw thing. I don't know what they were doing there. You know, it's kind of odd the way they were flipping back and forth and all that. But just the colors over Raw, man. But Basic Series 77, every figure looked the John Brown same, and they had the terrible arms. And then Basic 76 just looks fresh. Let's look at Basic Series 75. And Basic Series 75 was pretty decent as well. You had old arm articulation. You had a really great Randy Orton. That head sculpt on that Randy Orton, I still use it because of how good it was. You had the cool Lana in there, the Chris Jericho in there. Oh, this is a solid little football wave right here. Anywho, Basic Series 77 with the Corey Graves, another thing. Where's the slim chest, man? Corey Graves is not jacked like this in the chest, all right? He looks good in a suit, no doubt, but he wears a slim suit. We don't have any slim suited bodies for Mattel WWE figures. Every suited body for a Mattel figure has like a jacked chest and like everybody's massive, man. We need like a slim fit looking good. I hope that Jazzwares does this with the AEW figures as well. But Mattel is in serious need of a smaller torso. I know there's some out there that look a little bit better, and you have the Paul Heyman one, and you also have the, you know, Ultimate Warrior one looks okay, I won't lie, but we need like a slim, nice Finn Balor in a suit, or Corey Graves, you know, just looking real slim and nice.
But I think that Mattel needs to somehow come up with a way to get these body molds skinnier, because Corey Graves is a thinner guy, you know, he's a fitter guy. Like Finn Balor, if you wanted to have him in a suit, they need to release that kind of suited mold. Like, not everybody is this buff, so they need to come up with a mold that is, you know, slimmer, more like fitted look, instead of always this bulky stuff like with Shane and everybody in the past has the same mold, and it's just not accurate. Like,
but am I out of my mind? I don't know, man. I know I'm not out of my mind about the basics, man, but this wave right here, I don't even know what series we're on now. We're like 50 series into it now. We're literally not that far away from the newer arm articulation, the newer basics being like what they are. You know what I'm saying? They will overtake how many series there were of older. So before long, not too many months from now, or at least like a year or two maybe, there will be a time when there will be more waves of the garbage basics than waves of the good basics. And that's just, that makes me, that keeps me up at night, Brad. I think around this time, it was Elite 54 when they changed the Elite packaging. Elite 54 was also a time, like, they changed the aesthetic, right? And they went to, like, the white boxes. I kind of like the Elites in these boxes. They kind of looked pretty fire to me. I like the white boxes here with the square. That was kind of cool and updated. But the basics just made me want to jump off a bridge. I don't know. I didn't like it. I didn't like it at all. This is kind of a transition period. I know some of the figures had the newer arm articulation too, like the elbow rotation. I don't like that either. When we get Elites with that, I don't like it. Like, they did that with TNF Seth Rollins, I think. They did that with Cena from Elite 54. That's something that Trey doesn't like. But I will say, man, it's kind of like Elite 63, right? Like, Elite 54 was kind of a shift in time for WWE Elites, and then Elite 63 is when they gave them interchangeable hands. That kind of shifted the landscape. And now Elite 85 with Bray Wyatt, you know, double jointed arms, were kind of evolving here as we get closer to 100. So, I mean, WWE figures are getting better, but the basics, man, I don't know if they'll ever be the same ever again. And it all started with Basic Series 77, and that wave was just not good, man. I mean, overall, not a bad wave. Like, good head sculpts throughout. You know, you had some updates here and there, but again, same thing as current basics, man. Head sculpts. I mean, the suited body Corey Graves, I don't like the jacked chest, but it is a suited body. I guess I can give it a pass. But the Finn Balor, the head sculpt, and the knee pads is really all you can do. You can't switch the arms on any of these guys. How cool would it have been to take your Elite Finn Balor and take the sleeves and the armband off of the new basic and then pop it on our ringside exclusive Elite that we had gotten around this time? Would have been amazing, wouldn't it? Could have fixed up your Seth Rollins Elite. You know, he doesn't have the black armbands with the redesign, rebuild, reclaim on there. Doesn't have, like, the designs on there. You want to put that onto the Elite 37 Elite, make a fix up Seth Rollins. Can't do that because you can't pop the arms off. You may say the sleeves are right there at the top there. Could have acetoned it off, made for a whole new thing. But guess what, Brad? Didn't do that either. So Roman Reigns couldn't switch the arms. I don't even know if he had the orange arm gauntlets. I think they were solid black, but at least you could take the vest off. I mean, that's the best they could do, Brad. But I had to get on here and make this video because I wanted to dive into the, like, I had really forgotten about making videos on those new basics, but I literally made a video on those way back in the day, so that's kind of crazy. But I gotta go get some figures right now. Okay, I'm back. My Walmart actually had Series 4 of the AEW figures, and my boy Jonathan texted me. And so I picked up Cody, I grabbed a Kenny, and I grabbed a Hardy, so. Yeah. But anyways, guys, that is all I wanted to cover in this video, man. I wanted to cover Basic Series 77, the wave that changed it all. But before we get out of here, let's get into a random shout-out. Let me know what you guys think about Basic 77 and the change and all of that. I know we discussed it a little bit, man, but Basic's just, This shout-out's gonna go to Goober Bop, who says, RVD figures are always on point, as it should be. He's the whole effing show. Yes, ma'am. And I'm super hyped for Elite Series 91, man. Gonna be insane. I cannot wait to see what we get and how we get it and, you know, what the attire is and all that. Hopefully it's not a huge letdown. Hopefully the head sculpt is just phenomenal and all these different things, man. But that does it for today's video, guys. Thank you for watching. Let me know what you think of the basics. And, yeah, there's that mosquito. The mosquito's crossed the line. Don't be like them. You crossed the line.